Okay, let's have a look at a pen I recently bought. It's the Uniball Air, and I didn't know about this pen. I saw it earlier this week in WH Smith. That's a chain of stationery stores in the UK, and it was being advertised as a pen that writes like a fountain pen without leaking. And on the advertising board, it also said you can also increase the amount of pressure that you put on the pen for a thicker line. So I thought, oh, that sounds quite good. But I didn't buy it there and then, because you had to buy 3 or 4 of them, and they were 6 or 7 quid. So I went home and I saw that online you can get them for 2 quid, or just under 2 quid, including postage. So I thought I'd buy one. And unfortunately, it turns out there's broad and medium, which I didn't know, so I bought the broad one. But anyway, the claim of you can increase the amount of pressure for a thicker line, this claim also applies to the broad tip. Let's have a look. The first interesting thing is the tip is completely black. You can't really see well where the ball part of the ballpoint pen or the roller ball pen, whatever this is, probably more like a roller ball. You can't really see where the ball is because it's black, like the nib section. Okay, let's find out whether you can increase the amount of pressure you put on the pen for a thicker line. So I do light strokes up, and I press harder when I go down, and there's not much variation there. If I go very light and I press very hard, there is some. Some variation there, but you have to work really hard to get that. Now, I think that claim doesn't sound very plausible, at least here with the broad version of the pen. But they also make this claim for the broad version of the pen. Comparison: this is a normal Pelican fountain pen. It was the 200 series with an F-steel nib, the one with the metal bevel. And the F-nib, even though it's not being advertised as being flexible at all, it's quite flexible. I've got a few Pelican F-nibs for the M200 series, embarrassingly more than I should have. And I've got to say that all of them are flexible, so I think it will depend on the material or the year the nib is made, but basically all of mine are flexible. Why did I pick this pen? Because this fountain pen is not being advertised as flexible. The Uniball is being advertised as flexible. The Uniball isn't very flexible. Let's compare the Pelican. Much more flexibility here. And the good thing with the Pelican is that doesn't happen with some other fountain pens that are even being advertised as flexible. Some of the other fountain pens, you do pressure when you go down, you let go, but when you go up, there's still so much ink in the pen, or somehow the tines don't go back together, that after you spread the pen, it still stays white when you go up. But this is not the case with the Pelican. I can go up. It's getting out of focus here. Let's start a new line. I can let go and I can go up, and it gets the tines go together again. Comparison: the Uniball. Out of focus here again. Yeah, so I mean, it is a nice writing experience with that Uniball. And I'm saying that as a person who normally doesn't use roller balls and ballpoint pens very much. I try to avoid them, to be honest. I usually use pencils, and if not pencils, then fountain pens. So it is a very nice pen, but I can't really say that this claim of thicker line if you increase the pressure is true. At least not for the broad version. I should have probably measured the newtons you apply, you know, the pen force and those things, but I think from past blog posts I noticed that's not of much interest to people. So here more of a qualitative and less of a quantitative view of this pen. Okay, thank you very much for watching.